Of the hour. So today we have the privilege of hearing from an inspiring speaker who is passionate about helping women achieve their goals and their purpose in life. I am Marquetta DeVille, and it is my honor to introduce to you Pastor Jackie Morrison. Jackie is a woman of many talents, a wife, a mother, pastor, author, and wealth strategist. She is the founder and executive director of Reignited Women International, a nonprofit organization dedicated to empowering women. With over 23 years of experience in finance, business as a six-figure executive, Jackie has built an impressive wealth of knowledge and has overcome many obstacles. A lifelong trainer and to-go-to girl for networking, business, resources, training, and family balance, Jackie has launched and grown her business while maintaining a 9-to-5 family balance. Sorry, y'all. My college student is blowing my phone up for some reason. As a lifelong trainer and to-go-to girl for networking, business resources, training, and family life balance, Jackie has launched and grown her business while maintaining a 9-to-5, raising 6 children, and working in ministry. She is passionate about helping women in business expand their community, gain valuable knowledge to help them thrive, and to grow their business more efficiently, effectively, and strategically with God first. Amen. We welcome to the stage none other than Pastor Jackie Morrison. Amen, amen. Give God some praise in this house today. Hallelujah. Give God some praise in this house today. See, the baby just got up and she just did a dance for God. And the words of the dance is, you have enough. He said, God gave you enough. You are enough. You're more than enough. And you have always been enough. Amen. And so give God some praise that we are enough. Even in the moment that we felt like we weren't enough, that we were fearful, we were insecure, but God gave us enough. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you. It is an honor. It is a privilege to be before you today. I do not take this lightly. I do not take it lightly to be able to come in and be before the saints of God. And I feel like it is an honor to even be able to speak before the saints of God. And so we are going to, let's do protocol first, amen. First, giving glory and honor to God, who is truly the head of my life, and to Pastor Rankin, God bless you, to Pastor DeVille, Minister Marquetta, amen, and to First Lady Evelyn, amen. God bless each and every one of you. And last but certainly not least, y'all. To my pastor, to my covering, to my baby daddy, to my good thing. Amen. God bless you, Pastor Brian Morrison. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for always being by my side and supporting me in everything that I do, whether you want to support or not. Amen. Amen. And so, yeah, you're so funny. And so I definitely want to thank all of you who came on today, to my good friends, my brother and sister, the Foys, Maurice and Amber Foy, amen, God bless you, to my daughter and to my son-in-law for coming on today, God bless you guys for coming and supporting your mother, amen. And definitely want to thank Minister Marquetta and Lady Ev again for thinking of me and inviting me. Again, it is definitely an honor. Amen. And so we will be coming today from Psalms 46:5, and we're going to read that. If you would like to stand in reverence of God's word. And so Psalms 46:5, and it's a short passage, and it just says, God is within her. She will not fail.
Amen.
God is within her. She will not fail. God will help her at break of day. And then the Amplified says, God is in the midst of her, his city. She will not be moved. God will help her when the morning dawns. Amen. And so, Father God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable unto you, my Lord, my strength, my Redeemer. Oh God, remove self, oh God, and have your way in this place on today. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. So, when I got the invitation over a month ago, you know, from my sister Marquetta, y'all, I've been knowing this girl since high school, amen. And to speak, I immediately said yes, because there's some invitations we take that we don't have to pray for. You know, sometimes you got to pray over an invitation because you just can't go everywhere unless God sends you, right? But there's some that you can just quickly say yes to. And then, of course, this was one I could just quickly say yes to.
Amen.
And then as the month, you know, started to go by and time became closer, and I seen the program and I said, oh Lord, I'm on the program with Dr. Amy Rucker and Pastor Sharonda. And immediately the enemy began to play in my mind. He begins to play in my mind. Girl, you on this program? What you gonna say to these people? Cause you know, them, those is giants in the spirit, right? They're giant slayers and stuff like that, right? And so the enemy began to try, and he began to, you know, plant seeds of fear and doubt and insecurity. But how many of you know, as the theme says on the program, she believed she could.
Amen.
So she did.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Amen. She believed she could, so she did. And that has been the theme for the last 3 weeks. And Dr. Amy, just to recap a little bit, she talked about, she went through a history of several different women in the Bible. And she ended with build again. Build again, if you guys can remember, it was a mighty word. And then Pastor Sharonda came with let them live. And she talked about the importance of an intercessor and how it's not about you, but it's about others. And so today the Holy Spirit, as he was working with me, and I didn't even know really, you know, I jot down stuff, but wasn't able to put it all together until this morning. But he's leading me to talk about the unknown woman. The unknown woman, she believed she could, so she did. The unknown woman, amen. And so we know that it's Women's History Month, and in 1981, we know that Congress passed the public law which authorized and requested the president to proclaim the week beginning March 17th as Women's History Month. So Women's History Month started off as just Women's History Week. And so it wasn't until 1987 that it became Women's History Month. Okay, and so Women's History Month means is to recognize the specific achievements that women have made over the course of American history. And so I began to look up, because I'm a word person, and I look up words because I need to know the meaning of the words, because we say words all the time, but do we truly know the meaning of certain words? And so when I look up the word history, it said the study of past events, particularly in human affairs. The whole series of past events connected with someone or with something. And so there's many women who have made history and are continuously making history. And so let's talk about this for just a second. We know in the Bible, we know that Mary, the mother of Jesus, made history. We know that Deborah, she was a prophet. She was a heroine in the Old Testament who inspired the Israelites to a victory over the Canaanites. She made history. We know that Esther, she saved her people from destruction. She made history. We know of Sarah. We know that Sarah was the mother of nations. She was the mother of Isaac, and she made history. We even know in the world, we know that Harriet Tubman, she helped to rescue and to free slaves, and she made history. We know that Rosa Parks, she refused to give up her seat, but she helped change the law so that we can, as African Americans, can sit anywhere we want to on the bus, and she made history. We know that Michelle Obama, she was the first African American first lady of the United States of America. She made history. We know that Kamala Harris, she was the first African American vice president. She made history. But have you ever heard of Margaret Bailey? Have you ever heard of Margaret Bailey? Margaret Bailey was a United States Army nurse. She was she served in the Corps for 27 years. She served in France, Germany, and Japan. She was the second lieutenant to the help me with that word, babe. Colonel. There we go. Colonel, the highest achieving military rank in a nurse corps. She was a landmark for Black nurses in the U.S. military, and she became the first Black lieutenant colonel in 1964. But have you ever heard of her in history? Have you heard of Patricia Harris? Patricia Harris was a trailblazer. She was the first Black woman to serve as an American ambassador when she represented the United States in Luxembourg from 1965 to 1967. Have you heard of Patricia Harris? Or what about Constance Baker Motley? She's known as an attorney, an activist. These were many of her firsts, but she was the first Black woman to attend Columbia Law School. But have you heard of her before? These women are unknown history makers. And then there's some in the Bible. We go to Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat. Have you heard of Jehoshaphat before? Jesus. Jehoshaphat bravely rescued her nephew Joash from his murderous mother. His mother was trying to kill him, but she took him and she gave him to his nurse to raise for 6 years. And at that time, the king's ruling was to kill him, to kill them. And so Joash's mother, the daughter of Israel's wicked king Ahab and Jezebel, she claimed the Judaic throne and she sought to annihilate all the heirs of King David to put her own son to death. But have you heard of her? And so Jehoshaphat, she stole the baby. She kept him for 6 years, and he was hidden. And he was hidden until the priests and the rulers of Judah declared him king. So he was hidden because he needed to become king. And so Joash turned Israel back to God, bringing godly reforms and restoring the temple. But most importantly, because of her courageous faith, she was able to preserve the royal line of King David. Which we know that Jesus came from. But that was her position. Have you ever heard of the woman in the Bible? Her name was Noah. Not to be confused with Noah who built the ark. But her name was Noah. And so she was one of the five daughters of Zelophehad. And this daughter, she went to Moses and she asked for the legal right to inherit her father's property. And so we know back then, women didn't inherit the property. The sons inherited the property. They became the heirs and they became the next in line. But she went to Moses. She said, I want to inherit my father's property. And guess what? Moses agreed. And so she became the first woman in the ancient world to have legal rights to property ownership. Apart from their fathers or their husbands. And so the first point I want to make about the unknown woman is don't belittle any assignment that God has given you. Don't belittle any assignment that God has given you. We all have an assignment that God has given us, whether it be a big assignment, whether it be a small assignment, whether the assignment is known across the nation or whether the assignment is just known in your own house. Maybe you are a stay-at-home mom. Maybe you are the president of a national chapter of something. Do not belittle the assignment that God has given you. Point number two, your assignment is destined to make history. Your assignment is destined to make history. And as women, a lot of times we feel like we're not contributing, or we're not contributing enough, and will we be known, or will our kids remember us? Will our grandchildren remember us? How far back can you go and remember your grandmother or your great-grandmother or your great-great-grandmother? And so I want you to know that your assignment is destined to make history. It doesn't matter if your name is not known. You are destined to make history. Amen. Point number three, crowds may be applauding someone else, but your assignment is vital and just as important. Because sometimes we see our friends, we see different ones in our lives, and the crowd is applauding them. They're always posted on Facebook somewhere doing something. They're on TV getting recognized. They're in rooms speaking in front of huge crowds and large crowds, and everybody is applauding for them. Everybody is praising them and all of these things. But I want you to know that your assignment is just as vital and just as important. Don't demise your assignment on this morning. You are just as important. Just because you don't have 1,000 applauding for you, you maybe have that one. Maybe you don't have anybody at all. But your assignment is just as vital. Amen. So then we go to the woman with the alabaster box. If you remember her, she came in John 12. You can read about her in John 12. And she had an assignment. Her assignment was to anoint Jesus before his crucifixion. But see, no one really knew her assignment. Because when she came in with the alabaster box, and she began Jesus, she was crying. And she began to pour the oil all over Jesus. And she anointed him from her head to her feet. They couldn't understand why she was doing what she's doing. Why did she break that bottle? My favorite perfume is, I can't even remember what it is. But anyway, it comes in a beautiful pink bottle. And it costly. It's in the three digits. It's costly. And so when she walked in and she anointed Jesus, everybody around said, why is she taking all of that expensive perfume and pouring it on him? She's wasting it. See, they thought she was wasting it. People think they don't understand what you're doing, and they think that you're wasting your assignment. They think that you're wasting your life away. Right. They think that you have nothing to contribute and nothing to give. But I come by to tell you that your assignment is vital. And so she was pouring that oil on Jesus to anoint him. And they asked the question, why is she doing that? She's giving away a whole year's worth of salary.
Right.
She could have kept that bottle. She could have kept it. She could have sold it and made money from it. You know, everybody likes to make money. But she poured it. She poured it on our master because her assignment was to anoint him for his burial.
All right.
That was her assignment. And so everybody doesn't know your assignment. And guess what? Everybody doesn't have to know your assignment. It's not a requirement that everybody knows your assignment. Amen. The fourth point is history is made when you know your purpose.
Amen.
History is made when you know your purpose. And everybody does not need you, but somebody does. All right. See, you're not called to everybody. You know, I remember, you know, growing up and being young, I wanted everybody to be my friend. You know, so I would, you know, do things. I would, you know, pay people or, you know, buy them things so they would be my friend, you know. And because we feel like, you know, even people on Facebook and Instagram and all of these different things, you know, how many friends do I have? Right. You know, how many likes am I getting and all of these things, right? But your assignment is not for everybody, but it's for somebody. Amen. Amen. And so we look at the women, Michelle Obama, we look at Oprah, we look at Rosa Parks, and we look at Deborah in the Bible, and we look at the Proverbs 31 woman, and we look at Hannah and Sarah and Rebecca, and we try to mimic and we try to find our identity in these different women. Right? Because they're seen all the time. They're always at the forefront. They're always, you know, in front of people or the camera or whatever it may be. And so we try to find our identity in other people. people. Why? Because they're known. They're popular faces. And their stories are told and their stories are heard. And then we have these women in the Bible that we mentioned before who made just as great contributions into the world, but their name might not have been mentioned not even one time. And so you might be a stay-at-home mom. You might be working as a single mother. Or maybe you might be taking care of your elderly parents. Maybe you're just a wife. Maybe you're just a soccer mama. Maybe you're just a babysitter. You know, maybe your name isn't all over Facebook. It's not all fake book, like I like to call it, right? Maybe it's not all over Instagram or it's not all over TikTok. But God wanted me to let you know this morning that you are making his story. You are making his story. You're not making anybody else's story. You are making his story. Your name does not have to be known to make his story. He knows your name. He knows the amount of hairs on your head. Glory to your name, God. He knows you before you were even born and you were born in your mother's womb. You are making his story. My God. Jesus. And so your name may not be publicized, but you have an assignment. You are mighty and you are great in his eyes. And so if my name isn't written anywhere else, if my name isn't written in history, if my name isn't written in any of the history books, if my name isn't written all over social media or all over the news, if my name is not written in Wikipedia, I know for a fact that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. I can be that unknown woman, but I know that my name is written in the Book of Life. Amen. And so, Jesus, glory to your name, God. And so He gave me an acronym. And at first he started to give me the acronym for history. And then he said, no, I want you to go ahead and change that for Women's History Month. And he gave me an acronym for her story. Okay. Her story. Okay. And so the H in her story is for humility and humanity. Because as women, we must stay humble. We must stay humble for our families. We must stay humble for our assignments. And we must stay humble for God's people. Amen. The E is for equipped, because he has equipped us with everything that we need. Just like the baby praise dance a little earlier, we are enough. We have enough. He gave us enough. And so we are equipped for our assignment. The R is for revealed, revived, restored. And he's releasing us into our assignments. Amen. He's releasing us into our assignments, fully equipped. The S is for submitted to God and showing up. Amen. Whether I have one behind me, whether I have none behind me, or whether I have 1,000, I'm going to show up. I'm going to show up whether they're applauding or whether they're talking about me. I'm going to show up. I'm going to show up because God said, this is what you need to do. Show up. Amen. The T is for testimony, because it's my testimony that we are overcome. It's our testimony. It's us being able to talk about it, tell others about our testimony in order for us to make her story. The O is overcomer, because I am an overcomer. I am an overcomer. See, we all have a story. We all have a story. And if you don't have a story, guess what? You're making your story as we speak. You're making your story right now. And so it's about being an overcomer. We have all overcome something in our past, and we're going to continue to be overcomers. Amen. The R, the second R, is for reignited and rejoice. Because we rejoice in everything that God does for us, whether good or whether bad, whether trial and tribulation or whether free and whether blessed, we rejoice in God. Amen. And the Y in her story, the Y is for yes. The Y is for yes. Today, we have to give God our yes. We have to give him our yes, whether we feel like it, whether we don't. We have to give him a yes, because we have an assignment. And in order for us to complete that assignment, we have to be obedient and we have to give him that yes. Amen. It doesn't matter how small it is, how intimidated you may be, how fearful you may be, how you may feel like you're lacking. Like, you're lacking. God, I can't do this. I can't say that. That's not me. I'm not pretty enough. I'm not good enough. I'm not handsome enough. But give God your yes.
Right.
Give God your yes and yield to Yahweh. Amen. And so what are you doing to make history? What are you doing to make history? Are you walking in your assignment? Are you moving how he wants you to move? Are you being obedient, doing what he tells you to do? Or are you making up all kinds of excuses why you can't do it? Who's not supporting you? One thing I tell you, on Facebook, one thing that irks me, but I keep scrolling past, is people that say, well, this person ain't supporting me, or family not supporting me, and that was not supporting you. It does not matter who's supporting you, as long as God told you to do it, and he's got your back. He's got your back. God's got your back. You don't need any supporters. You know that God has your back, and he will be with you. He will be with you through the waters. He will be with you through everything that you're going through to make sure that you can implement your assignment. Amen. And so today I just want to just pray over the women in the room today. And I don't know who you are. I don't know who you are, but life has literally made us as women feel like we have to be perfect. Like, we gotta be the one to make sure that the house is clean. We gotta make sure that we be the one to make sure the kids are all together and they're doing what they're supposed to do. And we gotta make sure that we're upright and we're perfect so that our husbands can praise us. And we gotta make sure that, you know, on our jobs that we're giving and we're proving so much so that you know, we can be outstanding employees on our jobs or in our businesses, right? We gotta have that confidence. We gotta have that prestigious posture about us, right? And that's the picture, you know, that the Proverbs 31 type of stuff. You know, we're held to that example, right? We're held to that standard.
Amen.
When in reality, we're masking a lot of things.
Amen.
We're masking who we really are. We're broken on the inside. We're depressed on the inside. We're fearful on the inside. We're frustrated.
Yes.
We're confused. And we are actually bogged down by life. And so if you can go ahead and if you can put something on for me. And so we feel that, you know, as though we thought that we are contributing to our families and our friends and to our society, and we don't even know our identity. We don't even know who we are. We don't know who we are in God. We don't know who we are to people. We don't know who we are to our husbands. We don't know who we are to our children. We don't know who we are on our jobs, our businesses. But we're just walking around and we're masked. We're just walking around, what they say, you're just walking around doing the motions. Going through the motions. You're walking around just going through the motions. But God is saying this morning, and I'm so grateful for that song, it just ties right in, that you are enough.
Yeah.
God is saying this morning that you are more than enough. He's giving you every single thing you need to succeed and whatever the assignment is. And your name does not have to be in lights.
Right.
It doesn't have to be in lights. Your name doesn't have to be in lights, because he knows your name. And that's the most important person that needs to know your name. Amen. Is that he knows your name. And so I want to, if you feel led, that you feel like, you know what, Lord, I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. I don't know what my assignment is. You know, I'm taking care of the kids. I'm trying to make ends meet. I'm trying to get things done on a daily basis. I'm trying to work on myself. I'm doing all of these things, but I really don't know what my assignment is. I really don't know who I am in you. I don't really know what my purpose is. Maybe you're confused this morning and you don't know which way to go on a situation. Maybe you're just unsure. You're unsure. I want you to come to the altar so that we can pray for you. If you just want to, I just need prayer. I know there's some decisions that I need to make, and I just need prayer. Maybe, I don't know, maybe you've been going through a hard time and you need God to bless you. And you need prayer. Mm-hmm. I've been watching you the whole time. Amen. I've been watching you the entire time. Amen. I just need some prayer. I just need some direction. God, I just need some instruction. God, I just need something. Is this your oil right here? I just need you to speak to me. I haven't been able to hear from you in so long, God. I just need to be able to hear your voice. I need to be able to hear your voice. Amen. Marquetta, can you assist me, please? I need to be able to hear your voice. Amen. I need to be able to understand where you're taking me, Father. Just give me a glimpse. Just give me where you're coming down for prayer or where you're coming down to assist. Thank you. Amen. I don't know where you're taking me, Father. But wherever you go, I'm ready. I'm willing. Thank you, Jesus. I'm willing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And sometimes as women, we don't want to show that we don't have enough strength because we're taught to be so strong. We're taught to, you know, that we got to do it all, that we have to be all, that you know, everything falls on our backs. But it's okay. We don't always have to be all. We don't always have to do all, Jesus. There's times that we just want to lay and just lay before him. Amen. There's times that we just need to lay before him. Amen.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name, God. Glory to your name.
hers. How many bigger, God? It's bigger, God. It's bigger than what she thinks. It's bigger than what she can imagine, God. And so we thank you now for that. God, you're going to fix it, God. You're fixing even some things now that are untold. Things she hasn't been told. Things she hasn't told anyone. But she's been crying out to you about some things, God. There's been some things on her heart. There's been some things on her heart that she's been crying out, God.
Your heart, your mind, your healing.
Just say,
oh, yeah.